guys, welcome back. Okay, so today I played around in Juvia's Place's newest palette. This is the Nomad palette. Super, super gorgeous. Let me go ahead and just show you the packaging on this palette.
So, so very, very pretty.
Gorgeous. As usual, though. Okay, now I must admit, when I first saw them tease this palette on Instagram, I really wasn't feeling it. I wasn't feeling it. I was like, I ain't buying that. I'm not buying it. Because y'all know, if it ain't colorful, I really ain't checking for it. But after I saw the swatches for this palette, I was like, wait. Hold up. Okay. They got me with the swatches for this palette. I was like, that's kind of cute. Okay. Now, I don't even know why I was fronting like I wasn't going to buy it, because I have all of Juvia's Place's palettes and I'm a bit of a completionist when it comes to if I have a collection of something. So even if I hated it, I still would have bought it. But I'm glad I bought this palette. Now, this palette retails for $15 on the Juvia's Place website. You can use code FUMI to get 10% off. Okay, you can always use her code. But this palette really surprised me. Of course, I used it to create this look today, and I love it. I love this look. It's a really nice green tone, smoky fall look. I mean, I really don't have much to say about this palette because, in my opinion, Juvia's Place's shadows have always been amazing, nicely pigmented, easy to work with, but it seems like they're getting better. I don't know. Maybe I'm just getting better at learning how to use different shadows, but these shadows, I don't have no complaints about any of them. I used 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shadows out of the 9 in this pan. Now, there are these two here are shimmers, okay, beautiful shimmers. This yellow here has, like, glitter in it. I don't know. You probably can't see that on the camera, but this yellow has, like, some shimmery shimmers in there, and but it's a matte shadow, so I don't know what the point in that is. But the rest of these shadows are all mattes and just amazing, amazingly pigmented, easy to work with. I really enjoyed creating this eye look. So let me go ahead and just do some swatches for you guys. I don't want to jaw-jack too much because I did do this full look for you guys so you can check it out. So let's just go ahead and jump into these swatches. The swatches for this palette, you guys, as you can see, is a nice, beautiful, earthy, perfect for fall themed palette. Okay, I mean, it gives you a nice warm feeling, but there's also some cool tone vibes in here as well. So I like this palette. I really, really do. Like I said, Juvia's Place, they don't have a dud. In my opinion, they do not have a dud in their palettes. And this is no different. I love it. I enjoyed using it. I don't have that much more to say about it, okay? It's beautiful. It performed so nicely. And that's it. Let's just go ahead and jump into this look.
Okay, you guys. So I'm starting out this look a little differently than I normally do. I'm adding a brow bone highlight today because I wanted my eye look to be able to blend up nicely. So I'm just placing this lightest shade in the palette right underneath my eyebrow. Next, I'm going into this super dark brown. It's like a mossy brown shade. And I'm placing that all over my lid area. And I'm also using this shade to carve out the shape that I want for this smoky eye look today. As you can see, this color is very pigmented and easy to work with. I really, really like it. Next, I'm going into this dark green shade. And these don't have names if you're wondering why I'm just naming the color. This palette doesn't have names. So For this dark green shade, as you can see, I'm using it to just blend out the edge of that first shade so that it could be a nice blend up towards my eyebrow. And these colors blended beautifully. Next, I'm going into this beautiful pumpkin shade. And I'm just taking that and blending that right above that green shade that I just went into, because I want this to be a nice, beautiful gradient. And as you can see, those colors are blending beautifully. Now for the lid, I'm going into this super dark green shade and I'm spraying my brush, placing this shimmer all over my mobile lid area. This color is really, really nice. It's kind of like a gunmetal green, like a mix between a dark gray and a green. It's so very pretty with the other colors in this palette. Very nice. And on top of that, I'm going into this light gold shimmer shade. And I just gently started tapping that on top of that first shimmer. But I wanted to see how bright it could get, so I went ahead and sprayed my brush and just began to tap it on top, and it got much, much brighter when I sprayed my brush. So now I'm just blending out that crease area, making sure that everything is nice and cohesive for this look. I'm gonna go ahead and remove my tape now so I can move on to my face. Now for my face, I'm using my e.l.f. Poreless Primer today to prime underneath my foundation. And for foundation today, I'm using my Maybelline Superstay 24 Hour. And this one is in the shade Warm Coconut. And this shade is very, very warm. As you can see, it's almost orange, but it does blend in and look nice when I have my face all completed. This is one of my favorite foundations as far as the finish and the wear throughout the day. I love this Maybelline 24 Hour Superstay. For concealer, I'm using my JUVIA's I Am Magic Concealer, and I use the shade 11. So I'm just placing this in all the areas that I like to conceal and highlight around my face, using a damp beauty sponge to blend it out. Now to set this concealer in place, I'm going into my Becca Hydra Mist Set and Refresh Powder. This one is in the shade Golden Bronze, and I'm just using this to set all of the areas that I highlighted and concealed. And to set the rest of my face, I'm using my Too Faced Born This Way. This is the powder foundation in the color Spiced Rum. Now to bronze, I'm using my Hoola Toasted Bronzer. I'm so glad I picked this up during the 21 Days of Beauty, you guys. I really, really like this bronzer. It's nice and warm. It just looks absolutely beautiful on the face. Now to blush today, I'm going into my Sephora Pro Face Palette, and I'm using the shade Premier, and I'm just using that, gently tapping it to blush today. This palette is so pigmented, you really have to be careful with it. So this color is gorgeous. Now for highlight, I'm using the shade LA, and this highlight is very, very pigmented as well. So I'm just gently tapping that on my high points of my face. I'm also using it for my inner corner highlight today. I really, really like this highlighter. Now I'm going in with my eyeliner, and I'm just using my NYX Matte Liquid Eyeliner today. Not creating a bold wing, I'm really just lining the upper portion of my lid with a very slight wing today. Now for my lower lash line, I'm using one of my Morphe eyeliner pencils, and this one is in the color Falling for Green. It's just a beautiful green shade, nicely pigmented. And for lashes, I'm trying out this Balm Mad Lash Black Mascara. I actually really like this mascara. I mean, it's not anything amazing, but I do like the applicator. Now, I almost forgot to smoke out my lower lash line, you guys. I usually do this before mascara, but I'm just going back into that dark green matte shade and smoking out my lower lash line. And for lips today, I am using my Stila Liquid Lipstick. And this one is in the color Rubino. I just got this in one of my monthly subscription boxes. And I think it's a beautiful color for fall. And I'm setting this whole look with my MAC Fix Plus. And this one is in the scent Pineapple. And this is the finished look, you guys. I must say, I really, really enjoyed using this palette today. I mean, this eye look was so easy for me to create. No fuss, no muss. It's perfect for an evening out, a date night, a party night. I really, really like it. So hopefully you guys enjoyed watching. Thank you so much, and I'll see you on my next video. Toodles!